corridor was very important because it's really like sort of the ghost generator in Allerdale Hall. Every ghost I've created is at the end of a corridor, and it's something that comes from my childhood. When if you wanted water in the middle of the night in my grandmother's house, you needed to get up from bed, and the first thing you did on the way to the kitchen or on the way back was to go through a long, long corridor. And I always felt as a kid, when I come back, something's gonna be waiting for me at the end of the corridor.
Trick of the light.
The only thing we don't want is for it to be busy.
No.
It's to be clean. Let's try it again.
The Gothic corridor is an incredibly menacing space. The silhouetted outline of the archways is studded with rows of spear-like teeth, so it feels as if the shadows are closing in on any passenger, almost like some sort of torture chamber, and has a strange Gothic beauty to it.
Cut, that was perfect.
I arrived for pre-production and Guillermo took me through the house. And yeah, I was completely struck by it. It was just incredible, like these little knives lining the walls.
Yeah,
it was pretty amazing to see that.
The corridor is full of neat tricks, and we tailored it to fit Edith.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there's enough to fit the ghost and Edith, but it's a very tight corridor. It's not a normal measure for a corridor. And the other thing that we did, if you watch the movie really attentively, we repeated a wooden pattern on the columns 3-4 times, so the corridor looks out of focus. Because I wanted to create an effect like that, so it's disconcerting, but you don't know why. That was one of the high points.
I was obsessed with that corridor. The teeth, you know, in the corridor
are in Lucille's dress. Yes.
And so the first time I saw the corridor, I thought, oh my God, this is like her physically being connected to the house.
Yes.
Like she's almost birthed from this corridor.
Well, you were like the character that we wanted to be almost blended with the house.
I'm trying to appease Lucille and her anxiety, but I'm also trying to work out why they're not
watching. It works for me.
Good. Like giving her that look of like, Lucille, you're weird, and I'm trying to work out why does she know? Why does she know that?
No.
Maybe she sees ghosts like I do.
I'm happy with this.
Yeah, good.
There's a place in the house that I think very carefully Thomas actually avoids, and that's the long corridor. It's not a place where he is ever seen walking.
No.
It's an eminently sort of female space in the house. You know? It's reserved for Edith and for Lucille, and I think it defines Crimson Peak.
The archways seem like the silhouette of a woman.
Yes, that was the idea.
With a bonnet and a greatcoat.
What is curious is the shape of the grave of the mother is the shape of the mother in the corridor.
Yeah.
And the shape of the mother in the corridor is the shape of the corridor in Crimson and the shape of the keyhole that Lucille looks through. It's not that I ascribe any meaning to that, but I love the idea of doing those visual echoes, and absolutely it looks like a woman with a bonnet.
And teeth.
And teeth. It's a bonetta dentata.
In many respects, in any household, the kitchen is the heart of the house. That's absolutely true of the kitchen in Crimson Peak.
Axel?
You said you killed the dog.
And left it out there on its own. Thought it would perish in the cold.
Good. You were perfect on the delivery. I think you need to land that thing like it's nitroglycerin. When you land, you know?
Yeah.
If you land it strong, bam.
Guillermo and Jessica and myself were choreographing the tea-making scene. We knew that as brother and sister in their old kitchen, it needed to look like we'd lived there for years. We knew where everything was.
It was amazing to work there because everything was practical. So much so that when making tea, you always have to make sure you had a towel to push the kettle away from the fire to make sure you don't burn your hand. So it was a working kitchen, which is great when you're acting because you don't have to think about all those things. You don't have to fake it. You can just do what the character's doing, and one thing follows the other because of the practicality of the set. I felt like you could actually take the scullery set, lift it up and put it in any house, and with a good paint job, it's ready to go.
On action, we start there, we go to her.
Silver and a white.
We become an over, you know? Then she goes there, we stay here, blah, 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 all the way to Crimson Peak.
What did you say?
Crimson Peak.